sacrifice. Your word says, live and not die. Oh Lord, speak into my life.
Well, it's a day of celebration, amen? Yeah, it's a day of celebration. For some of us here, it's awkward in the sense that would have loved our mothers to be around, amen? But they're gone to heaven. There's some mothers here that have lost children. You know, there are mothers here that are having issues with their children. You know, they're praying and trusting God for a miracle. And one thing I know is this, that the reason why Jesus came is, you know, to show his love towards us and for us to accept that love, amen? So I pray this morning that we'll have the grace, you know, to receive the comfort of the Spirit, to have the healing of the Holy Spirit in our soul and our bodies, and even as Jesus has come to give to us, may we have the capacity to receive that in Jesus' name. What I've just prayed is a very simple prayer, but a lot of people in the world have issues, fundamental issues, because they've refused to receive the healing that God gives. You know, if you peel back some of the things that happen to great people, the traumas, you talk about a narcissist. You know, if you go back to the life of a narcissist, you find out that these are trauma, childhood traumas that, you know, that were not in any way attended to. You keep running away from your reality, you know, until you get to build those things that at the end of the day make you behave the way you behave. But I pray this morning that God will receive the love of Jesus in our hearts and will be everything that God has ordained us to be in Jesus' name. Praise the name of Jesus. This morning, we are, like I said, it's a day of celebration. It's not easy to be a mother. Oh, my goodness. And I now understand why in the scriptures, God is always saying, do this for a woman, do that for a mother. You know, two people went ahead and slept together. They had fun. Somebody stood up and kept, you know, the way he is. He's still straight. After about a month, somebody else is getting disfigured. He's spitting. He's getting sick. You know, before you know it, it's working somehow. You know what I mean? You know, it's not sleep, going to sleep the way he... Because there's somebody, tummy is bulging. You're carrying a human. It's a mystery on its own. And it doesn't just end there. You know, for the next 9 months of your life and until the day you give birth, it's sweat and blood. And even as you go in, there is 50-50. They say that the worst pain on earth is the pain of childbirth, you know. And I have a friend that on her deathbed, she was giving birth to her son. And the husband told me, he goes, you know what your friend said? She said, I will give my life for my son to live. And she closed her eyes and left, and her son lived. That's a mother's love. Next to God's love is a mother's love. Nobody can love you like a mother. Apart from God, I tell you the truth. Some women misbehave, but naturally. Any other person can compete with you, but not your mother. And that's why God shares most of his paternity, kind of his attributes, are maternal in nature. God is maternal in nature. God has that attribute of a mother in him. And that's where we're going to this morning. So the topic we have this morning, a mother as a pillar. Amen. Let's go to the book of Proverbs 31, verse 25. That's where the theme of our message is this morning. The Bible says that strength and honor are her clothing, and she shall rejoice in time to come. In some translations, in time to come, in the future. She must put her smile, no matter what she's going through now. Amen? And rejoice in time. That means that right now she's not rejoicing. Praise God. Strength and honor are her clothing. Strength and honor are her clothing. There's a high calling for a mother. There's a high calling of God for a mother. Because mothers are the first leaders. They're the first teachers to their children. They are the nurturers. And God understands the pivotal role that you need to play in humanity. and has given you these attributes of strength. When I see a woman, strength here is not physical strength, because the Bible says that you and I, we are weaker vessels. So it's not talking about physical strength here. It's talking about the inner strength. Amen? There's a system, there's a belief system that a virtuous, a woman of God, a mother, a godly mother should wear as a garment. Not Ankara, not lace. It doesn't appear even if you're wearing rags. But when a woman that is clothed with this in the inside appears, or in a home, things happen differently. And it's anchored on her belief system, who she believes in. A mother that clothes herself in prayers, a mother that has a connection with divinity, a mother that knows her source, that has a belief system in who God is and what God can do, this is her clothing. That even if everything is running haywire, her home is habitable. Her husband can go and come back. Why? There's a belief system. Because that belief system gives an attitude. An attitude is everything. She's clothed in strength. There's something she knows. There's something working on the inside of her that makes the home habitable. I have a friend. That same friend, the same girl that died and gave up her life for her son. I believe she made a wrong decision. She undermarried because her home was not conducive. Mothers, you are the sunshine. If the sunshine goes, can you imagine every day without sunshine? It will be gloomy days. You have that strength of a son to make things happen. Because if this woman, the Bible says she shall rejoice in time to come. That means there's a perseverance. It's just like the lion in the forest. Can I shock you? Yes, the Bible says you are the weaker vessel. In that equation, I am the weaker vessel. But just like the lion is not the strongest animal in the jungle. The lion is not the most intelligent. The lion is not the biggest animal. But his belief system makes him see the elephant as a meal. He sees an elephant and says, this one is my lunch. Why? There's something, there's a belief. That belief gives him an attitude of a warrior. And that's where I'm coming from this morning. I'm tired of women saying, how for do? You're just like this, how for do? How for do? No. She's clothed in strength. We'll go to who this woman is. She's clothed in strength that when things, the bad reports come, not like Job's wife, the man is sacked from the office. Now when he comes in, I've been telling you. The thing I've been telling you, it don't happen now. You're a very useless man. Very useless. You see now? You see, don't they happen? They don't chase you, Abby, for me to be paying rent. Or it happens to your son or to your daughter. You know, crisis. You see, one thing I will tell you, church, is this. This earth is a battleground. Just like the lion, the attitude you decide to put because of your belief system determines if you're going, no matter how strong that situation is. Attitude is everything, woman. If you're clothed in strength, there is no trial that can overwhelm your children. I bet you, because you know how to go to the place of power in the secret place. If it would take you 21 days not to eat, you go 21 days dry. You know that this must come to pass. If we should go further, there's a woman, let's go to that same, let's read from verse 1. A woman is somebody that we're talking about this morning. Let's go to 1. No, Proverbs, that's Proverbs 31st, verse 1. We're reading from verse 1 to 9 now. It said the words of King Lemuel, the prophecy that his mother taught him. What are you teaching your children? Teaching them how to keep malice, how to gossip, how to divide and rule. What are you teaching your children? I don't care how successful you are. The values you leave behind is what matters. when they know where church is. It's what you taught them. I was shocked one day. Not shocked, pleasantly shocked. We're talking in the car. And I told my children, I said, you see this Bagado Shudi Express? It is only a mad person that will leave the flyover, even if there's no flyover. Pass the first road, enter the second one, pass it, cross it, cross the third road. I said, by nature, according to Nigerian law, you are trespassing. It's a freeway. It's not meant for pedestrians, except you have, when you have an overhead bridge, you pass. But never in your life, no matter how impatient you want to be, don't do those runs. I have said it, and so just talking, my son said, somebody said we should, one day we're coming from church, somebody said we should cross the express. I just remember what my mommy said, though. I said, I'd rather take Jolad. I just took Jolad and went around. In my heart, I wasn't there, but something I had said resonated in him. You must be speaking. At times you're talking, but in the now you might think that they're not hearing. You keep speaking. Apart from speaking, keep living the life. Children learn more by what they see. Amen? Children learn more by your lifestyle. So this woman was talking to the son. What, my son? And what, the son of my womb? And what, the son of my vows? Give not thy strength unto women, nor thy ways to that which destroyeth kings. This is a woman. And this is a woman talking to a man child. So, you know, at times, there's something about God. When I was growing up, and I know it happened to you, when your father appears, everybody behaves as if they're saints. But you can throw tantrums. Your father, my mother, can I even say something 30 times? You know, that's a woman. So there's a place for the men. But today is Women's Day, amen? What he's trying to say here is this. They are lost from the mouth of your mother. And he was telling the son, though he's a king, a queen talking to his son, Lemuel, it is not for kings to drink wine, nor for princes strong drink. These are the mother's laws to the son. And can I shock you? We're talking in the car. I am Pastor when we're coming. And we're talking about how Nigeria, you know, how people, you know, just behave anyhow, you know, with impunity. And because they know that when they do anyhow, they can drop one name and then they get scot-free. But do you know that one of the laws and the commands of God is that the children should honor their father and their mothers? Can you go to Exodus 20? It said, honor thy father and thy mother. In the time of old, they wanted to somehow, you know, break it down. What they're supposed to give to their mothers, to their fathers, they will now say is talim and kumim. And people still do it today. The honor, the courtesy that you're supposed to give to your mother and your father, you say, because I've paid my tithe, therefore mother should wait. These are laws. And when laws are broken, there are consequences. That's why if you decide to go to that upstairs and fall, you will fall very well. The law of gravity. And what most of us, especially in the Pentecostal cycle, does is that we think we can suspend the laws of God because of grace. Grace only helps you to fulfill the law. Jesus said, I've come to fulfill the law and the prophets. So no matter how wonderful you are in church, if your mother cannot eat and yet you can afford to go to a restaurant and eat very well, there's something wrong. And your wife too. Honor thy father and thy mother, which is the first commandment with promise. And you wonder why you're toiling. And you wonder why you're having one accident or the other. Something trying to cut your life short. Meanwhile, there's something you're violating. Anytime you violate a natural law, something happens, because the laws were meant to protect you. And that was just this woman was trying to tell the we'll go back to Lemuel, tell the son, don't give your strength to women. You're a king. You have the power. But a power without control is no power. You can have them like Solomon had them. You can get them from anywhere. You can take them to any hotel, any brothel. No man can see. And as for the king, you have the wherewithal. But power without control. Lemuel, don't. In terms of drink, he said, don't drink and forget the law. Are you saying that law again? And perfect the judgment of any afflicted. Because what goes up comes down. That's the mother's law. Rather use your strength, Lemuel. Look for the weak amongst you. Because true religion is actually to go to the orphans and to the widows and to visit the prisons. And that is why we are. You know, one day I woke up and I told God, I said, I would, Father, you give me a piece of land in all the big areas of Nigeria where I can situate the orphanage. And I will be in that community to make sure that the big men and the big women, most of the times, will bring their children to see the other side of life. And when they get into power, they should remember humanity. Because what happens and what is still happening is that we are raising, I'm sorry to say that, beasts in human nature, even in Africa. When you are blessed with so much and yet your neighbor goes. Somebody sent me a video last night. I broke down. In this Lagos, a woman have like about 3 children. They are all having kwashiorkor symptoms. The children, they look at the tummies. They can't. They are in this country. And I said, where people are buying a car for 25 million, and not just one, maybe 5 at a stretch, it ought not to be so. That's the strength. That's the strength. You have the strength, but you're channeling it. That's what he's telling Lemuel. Channel it in a way that humanity and God will be glorified. Go ahead. Let him drink and forget his poverty and remember his misery no more. 8. Open thy mouth for the dump and the cause of all such are appointed to destruction. Are you seeing what the mother is saying? Open thy mouth for the dump. There are people that can't speak. There are people that are in prison. Not for anything that they have done. Nothing. But because there's nobody to plead that cause. You say, Lemuel, that is exactly why I'm your mother. And that's why I'm writing this law that you follow it. So that your end will be peace. And God is looking for women, mothers, that will make generational impact, like Lois and Eunice. The Bible says that, according to 1 Timothy 5 or so, it said that same faith, that unfeigned faith that was in your grandmother, was found again in your mother Eunice and in Timothy. The God of what? Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Take generational impact through women. So don't say, I am a woman. No. There's so much. You are the author of God. Like a woman said here, God sides you. You will say, why did God have to side Sarah? Sarah was the one that did not have faith at the end of the day. She was the one that orchestrated and told Abraham, go and lie with Hagar. She's the one that still came back to Abraham and said, tell Hagar to go. In the natural course of things, Abraham was right or wrong? Was right. Abraham was in his own. And Sarah said, go and meet Hagar. So let us help God. That's why as a man, men in the house, don't miscalculate the importance of a woman. A woman can end your destiny. Check through history. Let's read the scripture. Don't ever in your life miscalculate the power of a woman. It is the beginning of sorrow. You can ask Adam. If you see Baba Adam, ask him, how far? If you see Elijah, ask him what made him to run. Amen. 1 Peter 3:7. He said, likewise, ye husbands, dwell with them according to knowledge, giving unto the honor to the wife as unto the weaker vessel, and as being heirs together of grace for life, that your prayers be not what? So a man's prayer, a husband's prayer can be hindered because he does not live with the woman according to knowledge. And this morning, God just made me understand something. When he's saying live with her according to knowledge, I'm a complex person. And that's the way we are. A man is external. A woman is deep. A woman is deep. Every month, a woman sees her period. Life, because the Bible said that life is in the blood. Abby? Life is in the blood. Every month, the woman passes a part of life out. And that makes her hormones go haywire. I want to marry. Do you understand how a woman works? Do you understand? Have you cared to read about the engineering of a woman? How her moods and what she's made of? And then all she just needs, because not every time a woman wants sex. No, she's not meant for, she just wants affection. You have not talked to her the whole day. You didn't send her any text. You came back seeing her, she has gone to work. She from there went to the market. From the market, she has entered the kitchen. And she has cooked, everybody has eaten. And in the night, there's no word of thank you. Dear, how are you? That is living at with that according to knowledge. Just little words, because we are excited by the things we do, what we hear. That's all. And then at night, she's going to go to work, leave the house by 5 a.m. in the morning. You want the other one, the other room assignment. And she's not forthcoming. Because naturally, you have to wind her up. You have to be in her space. She needs to be loved before you can get her to that realm. I want to marry. And marriages are crashing. And it's because now we lack knowledge. I said, my people perish for lack of knowledge. You don't treat a woman like you treat a man. They are two different entities. They are not the same. A man does not need to hear me say, I love you. A woman needs it all the time. A woman needs it all the time. I love you. It sounds so simple, but to her, there's something. A woman needs to be touched. The man just needs respect. Submit to him, respect him. But the woman needs that. She needs to be reassured all the time. Deal with her according to knowledge. If I buy 5 trousers for Izuchukwu, regardless that he grows every hour, I don't know. Even if I buy 5 trousers, do you understand? For him, for 3 months. I mean, nature, according to what the God will say, does not expect me to buy just 5 skirts for Chiamaka or Uju. Nature expects me to know that the woman likes to dress. Amen? Yes. You will come to our wardrobe. It is full, and yet we are looking for what to wear. That's a woman for you. Where is that king? That king said, dress up. I just want to show you off. That's what a man. My mother is from Nnewi. An Nnewi man. Eh? My wear slippers. But his pride is that his wife is coming and is glittering with the children. They got that from the Bible. It's not that, because already he knows who he is. A woman just needs to wear that thing and then feel that in anger. So I can't, that is according to, dealing with her according to knowledge. And I want to ask you, when last did you buy even pants for your wife? When last? Do you know the color of her powder? You see, let me tell you, most unbelievers have attitude. There's a belief system that they have that makes them more successful than us that shout and shout ho, our voices ho in church. And that's because of the things that they know. The Bible says in Proverbs that he that findeth a wife, findeth what? A good thing, and obtaining favor from the Lord. And you are toiling with your favor. How dare you toil with what God says is your favor?
And every year it looks as if God does not answer prayers. There are laws we are breaking. Children, there are laws you're breaking. Fathers, there are laws you're breaking. And God can never be man. Those that understand it, if you look at a husband and wife that understands this, that flight is like this. They go so far. But when you bring, that is how my father loved my mother, you'll be there. We need to repent. We need to go back to scriptures. It's not about women liberation. Most women these days, don't they even tell you they don't need men. We are in a very precarious stage. Yo. I have a friend that went to US, bought sperm. She has a boy and a girl. She bought sperm. I can actually give my eggs. I'm very fertile. If I want to make money now, when I get to the US, I tell them, extract everything. I can have 100 Ngozi's everywhere in the world. You don't understand what I mean? I sell my egg if I want to. Eh? This person will incubate Ngozi somewhere and put it in another womb. So what we're talking about, you see, God has given us our spouses, our family. I shared something with my children the other day. A man came to social media and was saying that your wife is not part of your family. I don't know how many people saw that. You saw that? That you saw it? That his wife is not part of his family. That the people that are in his family is his mother. I said, oh, mother, how? You see the lie of the enemy. Somebody that said that, but what, whom God has said that when you have obtained and you have obtained a good thing, and then you're dealing from year to year, from year to year, from month to month, you're trifling with what God says is your favor. See, there's nothing you do for your mother that can be enough. I'm so sorry for some of us that didn't have or don't have a very good relationship with our mothers. I'm so sorry, but it's just a one-off. It's not the natural thing. Today usually is not a very, it's a good day, but it's a day that gets me, I'm sorry, I'm emotional person, and it's all part of me. I don't have apologies for that. When I think back the sacrifices my mother made, that's what pains me. I said, why this woman, why didn't she live so long so I can even get a brand new car, do something for her? You know the pain of menses just for a month? The pain of pushing out the baby? The pain of your quality after doing that? Raising a child, because when a child goes wrong, it is the shame of her mother. Bible said so. When a child does not measure up, it's the shame of the mother. Society so much has saddled the woman with so much responsibility. That's why I say, if you can, as a woman, I was a career woman, but I had to go at a time that I needed to go. Because see, at the end of the day, you know what they said, in the future, it's not now. At the end of the day, would you have a good relationship with your children? Would they say mommy was there when they needed mommy most? Or you were in Abuja? Or you were in one conference? I know you have to put food on the table. I know of a story. It was told in this church where we had the children's whatever convention one year. A woman, probably a single woman, she had to put food on the table. She goes to Dubai, run around, not knowing that her younger brother was sleeping with her daughter. You can be successful, but are you valuable as a mother? You can equally be present, but the presence is maybe just to watch African movie. No, your presence must make valuable impact in your children. It's a Herculean task. Oh, how I wish you can be, men can be in position to know what mothers feel. She's concerned. That's why every babalawo, any fake, anywhere you see women, they're looking for solution. It's not about them. Either husband wahala, children wahala, mothers wahala. They're looking for solution. They will tell them to, it is happening here, this one mountain here. It's women. Because the woman have that capacity to feel. She can't feel. There's a place at Rifakode, as early as 7 o'clock, Some men are eating hot rice. One die, one down. I said, come on, Elipa. I hope you people like you gave them. I want down. My children know that. I said, Mom, you look for trouble. I say, sorry. That's part of me. Amen. He that findeth a wife findeth a good thing and obtains favor from the Lord. I would to God and I pray that for every mother, at the end of it all, it shall be said of you by God, well done, thou good and faithful servant. I pray that will be my welcome and that will be your welcome. Because truly, truly and sincerely, your work is not easy. Your calling is not for the faint-hearted. You are the gateway of life. You are the author of God. You are everything. And on light and world, you know, there is no father of God. There is only mother of God to tell you how God can never do without you. I didn't say that. Scriptures documented that. So as a mother, this morning I call you into the secret place. Enough of wasting of time on things that don't add value. On things that don't add value. You are a mirror that the children will see through God. Your life, your sacrifices. And I'll put a caveat. As you do all that you do, please learn to take care of you. Learn to take care of you. If you can afford to go to a spa every month or every 2 months, take care of yourself. Take care of your mental state. If you're a woman of the secret place, you will live a life of gratitude, knowing who you believe that he will never leave nor forsake you. That regardless what you might be seeing today, all the negatives and the trials, you know that God can never lie. He did not call the seed of Jacob to seek him in vain. When they brought Jesus to the temple after a few days or months of his birth, Simon looked at Mary and said, a sword will pierce through your heart. A sword will pierce through your heart. And as I speak here, their grandmothers, their mothers, that swords are piercing through their hearts. Because of what the children are going through. But I tell you, even as Jesus resurrected, your children will resurrect. There's no power in hell that will keep them in the depths of the pit. There's no power in hell that will not make you see the travail of your soul. I want to thank you for everything that you do in the home front, in the church. Everywhere, even in your family, that family is blessed because you're there. Don't ever go weak in prayers. That's where your power is. And as you do, may the God of heavens bless us. Give us long life and sound health to enjoy the fruit of our labor. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Can we be upstanding?
Church,
let the church
say.